Good evening. This is Ganzonomy. Tonight's video is going to be a little bit different than most of my other videos. Most of my videos focus on cameras that have positive qualities to them. It could be providing photography to the masses, being unusually high-end, aesthetically pleasing, influential. This camera is none of those. This is the 1947 Kodak 35 RF. Arguably the worst 35mm rangefinder camera that Kodak ever made. The first thing you will notice is a gear. This gear turns the front focusing element of this camera's lens. As you can see, it turns. And the gear turns with it. This was then coupled up to the rangefinder of the camera. And that little tiny hole in the middle is your viewfinder. And this window. And this window is your coupled rangefinder. And then just for good measure, we have some sort of arm with a distance line on it that tells you how far away your desired object is from your camera. Looking up on top of the camera, we have your winding knob to wind to the next exposure. We have your rewind knob to wind the film back when you're done. We have your exposure counter, your shutter release, and even something that would let you pick what type of film it is you are shooting with. Would be decent, but no. And the reason for that is the shutter mechanism and the winding mechanism can only be described as, who designed this? Why? First things first, the winding mechanism doesn't work right. And that's even from the factory. So you can wind. And the shutter doesn't even work, which is apparently a common feature of the Kodak 35. That being said, if you find one that works, you have time, bulb, and 5 speeds ranging from 1/10 of a second to 1/200 of a second. You also may pick an aperture ranging from f3.5 to f16. On the bottom of the camera, you will see the tripod mount and a funny little butterfly looking thing that we flip it out. It flips out. Let's see if I can get it to flip out. Hold on, I'll get it to flip out. Okay, so apparently it doesn't flip out, and I'm a Muppet. You turn the key clockwise, and then the back of the camera comes off. Here we see the back of the camera with the pressure plate and the used Kodak 135 film. The film was much better than this camera. And we see inside here the inner workings. You have your take-up spool, your winding gears, the chamber to hold your roll of film, and through the back you can see the shutter. This is your rangefinder coupling window, and up here is your viewing window. Your rangefinder window is a little ways off from your view window, so you have to move between the two. I've never actually shot with this camera because, frankly, I can't get it to work. And that's a shame, because for all the horrible things that this camera possesses, it has exactly one redeeming quality. It has the Kodak Anastigmat Special f3.5 50mm lens, a four-element Tessar design at a normal focal length of 50mm that on other cameras is quite capable. The lens is not a bad lens. It's not an Ektar, it's not a Medalist, it's not a Signet 35, but it's a completely respectable lens. Because it's sharp, because of the fact that it's got luminization as element, says L on the front. It's just that the rest of the camera is such a pile of rubbish that in no way could I recommend ever shooting with one unless you're a masochist or giving this as a birthday gift to somebody unless you're a sadist. So on that unfortunate note, this is Ganzonomy. I hope you enjoyed this video as a slight diversion from my other videos, as it's less technical and more realistic. Oh, and this is the shutter thing up here that releases the shutter, but naturally, as with everything else on this camera, it doesn't work. Thank you for watching and tolerating this overview of this maligned camera, and rightfully so, maligned. Please like this video if you liked it, and subscribe. More content is on the way. Thank you, and have a good night.